Hello there, Georgie. How are you?
I'm so very well, Christian Bale. All the better for talking to you. Congratulations on this film. I've got to say, it's such an incredible cast. I was watching it and every time someone popped up, I was like, Jesus, they're in this too?
It was obviously less of a surprise to me, but certainly as David and I would be sitting and putting this together and then he was telling me who he'd spoken to or we would speak about who might be great for a certain role, and they kept on saying yes to it. So we were very blessed with the incredible talent that we got for this film.
I don't know if I can talk about this.
I'm about to do something that could cost me my life.
The cuckoo is in the nest and the cuckoo is about to be trapped.
Why do you think they all did say yes?
I would say David's reputation is one that he's a very unique, very interesting, very passionate filmmaker who makes absolutely fantastic films. And then it was probably, yeah, but there's Bale in it. But in spite of me, they still said yes.
I think you may have been one of the draw cards as well.
Thank you very much.
The film was a collaboration with Christian and director O. Russell that took place over 6 years.
You have this unique style or this unique approach to your films. You don't like to chat about them in offices, but rather at a humble American diner?
Yeah, I just find sitting in offices, I walk in and anything creative in me dies as soon as I walk into an office. So we liked sitting in a diner that actually was the same place that David and myself, we first met about The Fighter, and then we would sit and talk about American Hustle together, and then we just really went much deeper and met for years in these diners.
Have you thought about cutting out the middleman and just opening your own?
I'm sure we single-handedly supported that diner during that time. So, yeah, maybe we should get a cut of that one.
Now, I know that Rowan Atkinson was one of your early acting mentors. With a cast such as this, with so much talent, was there anyone that you were watching on set and thought that you might be able to glean that from them and add it to your approach? Who did you learn from the most?
I decided long ago that you mustn't ever imitate anybody else because you're only going to be a second-rate version of who they are, you know? So obviously you got such a cinema legend as Robert De Niro, God forbid you ever try being like him. You have to trust that what you're going to do is become unique. And trust in your own life and experiences and bring those to bear in any film. But my God, what a cast we had in this. We were so bloody lucky.
Did someone slap you, Bert? Because you have a red mark on your face.
I got slapped. I got punched.
Oh, no.
Being from Australia, of course, we have a vested interest in our girl Margot. What's it like to work with her?
Oh, she's fantastic. You know, she jumps in and she's very bold and she's so much fun and she's got a great spirit that was really good for this character of Valerie, who's a really intrepid soul and, is kind of based on a lot of very impressive women artists from the Dada movement of the time, and she does an incredible job.
Margot's not the only Aussie he's worked with lately. Christian also starred in the latest Thor film.
So this is my vow. All gods will die.
As huge as the Marvel franchise is, he didn't really know what he was getting himself in for.
I know that your family actually had to peer pressure you into joining it. Do you have any regrets?
No regrets at all. You know, had such a wonderful experience and we were so fortunate to get to come to Australia. But man, what a wonderful time we did have. What a beautiful country. We got to travel a little bit with him. We went on the train again up and down. We went swimming up and with Sundays and Lord Howe and whatnot and wonderful people out there. You know, obviously spearheaded by Chris Hemsworth, who's just such a gent, and Taika Waititi, who's phenomenal. So no regrets whatsoever. Really enjoyed ourselves.
Well, we'd love you to come back. Enjoy yourself some more. You're a gent too, Christian Bale. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
Amsterdam is in cinemas everywhere this Thursday, October the 6th. That is a remarkable cast.
Yeah.
It really is.
And David O. Russell is one of the great filmmakers.
And
in the
he has a remarkable accent. What was that with Christian Bale's voice?
I was not expecting that voice.
No.
Yeah.
It's almost like he's acting when he's on the screen.
How fun they just come to Australia and have these amazing holidays.
Yeah. I feel like
all you ever hear them talk about is the amazing places they've been to.
They should publish like a tourism guide for us.
He loved the Gan, you know?